Hello, welcome. Today we are going to discuss transformation of signals and systems from time domain to frequency domain. Here we discuss why we transform any time domain signal to other domain or frequency domain. First, we see the content. In this, we will see what is signal processing, what are the drawbacks of time domain representation, what is meaning of transformation, and different transforms. First, what is signal processing? Signal is a physical quantity that carries some information and it is part of one or more independent variables. Anything that carries some information can be called as a signal. Examples of signals that we encounter in our daily life are speech, music, picture, video, etc. Some other examples of signals are electrocardiogram, which provides us information about health, person's heart, seismic signals, which are used to measure the intensity of earthquake, AC power supply signals that we have at our homes and offices, etc. Associated with all mentioned signals and other signals can be said to be generated by a system. A system may also be defined as a device that performs an operation on the signal. Suppose we want to amplify a signal. In this case, amplifier acts as a system. Similarly, if we want to filter out some noise out of signal, we pass through a filter. In this case, filter is a system. Hence, a system is an interconnection of components that performs an operation on an input signal and produces output. This production of desired output signal from an input signal is known as signal processing. In our day-to-day life, we encounter different devices like mobiles, ovens, laptop, AC power supply, etc. Signal processing is required. So, signal processing is nothing but signal processing is nothing but with the help of system we produces that different desired signals from raw signals or input signals is nothing but signal processing. Then transformation. In this transformation we will see what is need of transformation. If we observe the time domain signal, then we get the information regarding shape of signal, its frequency, type of signal, either it is periodic or non-periodic, one cycle period, but it does not provide the information about the frequency component present in given signal and in what propagation they are mixed. So this is one of the drawbacks of time domain signal. Next is regarding system. Any time domain system is represented by differential equation. The solution of differential equation is much difficult for assumption and solving constant using initial conditions. If we observe the experiment, prism experiment, we all are familiar with prism experiment. White light when passed through a prism gets split into different 7 colors known as spectrum. White light is made up of different 7 colors and each color corresponds to specific frequency of visible spectrum. Hence, analysis of light into color is actually form of frequency analysis. The prism splits white light into separate colors, that means different wavelengths. What the prism does to light transform does to signals. So, due to these two drawbacks which are occurs in continuous time signals and system, we use different transforms. First one is Fourier transform. Fourier transform is used for both continuous time and discrete time signals and systems. Second one is Laplace transform. Laplace transform is used only for continuous time signals. And next is Z transform, which is used for only discrete time signals.